everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.3 Developer Beta 2. Also, they released iOS 14.3 Public Beta 2 just after this. And this is, again, a late release in the day. They did this with Beta 1. Now they're doing this with Beta 2. I don't know if this is a new trend, but it released around 5 p.m. Eastern time or later in the United States. So it's pretty interesting to see them release that this late in the day. Now, this came in at 385.4 megabytes on my iPhone 12 Pro and was similarly sized on the iPhone 6S Plus, iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020, and the iPhone 11. Now, before we talk about the build number, Apple also released iPadOS 14.3 Beta 2 along with macOS 11.1 Beta 1. So those were released around the same time today. macOS came out a little bit earlier. Now let's go ahead and go to the build number. We'll go to settings, then we'll go to general and about. You can see the build number is 18C5054C. And this particular build is probably a couple away from a final version, but we'll know that within the coming weeks. But this particular update came out 1 week after the first one, which is kind of a surprise. I thought they'd do a bi-weekly update, but maybe because they want to get out Apple Pro Raw before the end of the year, they pushed this out and maybe they're rolling this out more quickly. Now, they did update the modem, at least on the iPhone 12 Pro. So hopefully you have a modem update as well if you were having connectivity issues. I personally wasn't, but I know of some people having issues with Wi-Fi. So hopefully it fixes that. Although that's not specific to the modem update, it's specific to other updates as well. So hopefully this fixes an issue with LTE or 5G if you were having that on the newer phones. Now, as far as any new features, well, Apple's Pro Raw, I talked about before, it's for the iPhone 12 Pro and the iPhone 12 Pro Max. And once you turn the option on in your camera settings, you'll have Raw in the upper right. I don't think it was working properly before because when I take a photo here, I'll take that photo, go over to the photo, you'll see if I tap on it, it now says Raw. So it's a Raw photo, which means we can edit it a little bit better. We can adjust things with more dynamic range. Basically, we can really get a lot more detail out of things. If maybe we go to exposure, we can change the exposure and we won't lose a lot of detail in the image. So this will be really nice in the future for those of you with Pro displays or Pro iPhone 12s rather, and maybe they'll bring it to other devices, but I'm not really sure that they will. But it's nice to at least see that on this device since it is a promised feature with the 12 Pro and the 12 Pro Max. Now, something else they've changed is if you're using a custom icon for an app. This is one I just created quickly since I don't have a lot of custom ones, but if you go ahead and tap on this and it opens up, you'll get a new drop down saying it ran an app shortcut. So instead of opening the shortcuts and then switching over, you'll get this little drop down and it says app shortcuts for Overcast is what I set it up for. So it's kind of interesting that it just pops down every single time. I don't know of a way to get rid of it, but it seems like this is a beta 2 change or feature. I'm not sure I would call it a feature per se. Now, something else that's new or that some people are seeing is if you have the podcast app and you open it up, you'll get a new pop-up. Not everyone is seeing this. I didn't see it on the 6S Plus, for example, but it did show up on the 12 Pro. So you'll see it says powerful stories, listen anytime, anyplace, Siri suggestions. Some people are getting different pop-ups. I'm not seeing one other than what opens when you first install the app. So you may or may not see that. Now, another thing they've changed that they added last time, but they've removed is if we go into our settings and then we scroll down to privacy, scroll all the way to the bottom to analytics and improvements, they've removed the fitness app sharing. So we will see Fitness Plus coming soon. And some people are still seeing the fitness app installed on their iPad. I'm not, but some people are seeing that. But there was a fitness section in here to share that data with Apple. They've since removed it with this update. So maybe they'll bring it back when we're closer to the release of Fitness Plus. But right now there's nothing there. So they have removed that. Now, other than that, there's nothing else new that I was able to find throughout the OS. I'm not seeing anything in particular that's super exciting. Home doesn't see any different, although I do have all of the icons filled out, which is nice. However, the OS in general feels fairly snappy. So if you go in and maybe to the iPhone 6S Plus, this is the first time I've opened music, and you'll see things seem to be loading nice and fast. I've had someone else tell me the same thing. So they're seemingly seeing improved animation speeds. You'll see the camera opened really fast on the 6S Plus, and on the iPhone 11, you should have the same sort of experience. So if we go into, let's do the same thing, music here, that's the first time I'm loading it on this iPhone 11. You'll see that it should be fairly responsive. So nothing really terribly different. The camera should open nice and fast, and I would expect a good performance overall. Now with iPadOS 14.3 Beta 2, don't expect anything different here either. There's nothing really new, but it does feel very fast and fluid. So you'll see it's nice and smooth. This is the ProMotion display, but it's super smooth. No issues there. And hopefully we'll get some additional features with the iPad in the future, but right now there's not anything in particular. Now, as far as resolved issues, well, I mentioned the issue with ProRAW, and Apple actually mentioned this specifically, that they fixed some issues with ProRAW, and they also fixed some issues with HomeKit authentication that was not working properly. So if you were having issues with your HomeKit devices, that should be working properly now. Now, there is still one known bug that they call out, and it has to do with iPadOS 14.3 Beta 2, and it currently does not support shared iPads. So do not install it on the device if you're sharing an iPad. So if you have multiple accounts and it's shared, it's actually cautioning you not to install it. So beware of that. And then other than that, there's nothing else that I was able to find. Now, as far as battery life, I've been using my iPad on the beta full time. And if we go to the battery life, you'll see I have 3 hours and 11 minutes of screen on time today. And I charged it to 100% at 2:17 PM. Before that, I used it for a couple days prior to charging it. And I'm getting the normal 10 hours I would with my iPad. Now, depending on who you are and how you use your device, I've seen some people say that they're not getting great battery life with the first beta. It's a beta, so that could be expected, but some people are seeing good battery life, others are seeing excellent battery life, and others are seeing terrible battery life. So it will take a few days to know for sure, and if you'd like me to do a follow-up about it, please let me know in the comments below. Now, I did run a benchmark since I did say this is performing well. It feels nice and fast. Let's go into Geekbench here. I used Geekbench 5, and on the iPhone 12 Pro, you can see I scored 1,593 for single core, 4,034 for multi-core. If we take a look at the iPhone 11, which I know a lot of people have, we'll go over to here. We have 1,333 for single core, which is actually pretty good. Multi-core is 2,803, which is okay. Maybe if I ran it a little bit later, it would go up, but that will give you a general idea of what to expect on it. Now on the iPhone 6S Plus, I ran it here as well, since this is an older device. So let's go into Geekbench, and it scored 539 or 1,005 for multi-core. And then finally on the iPad Pro, I ran it here and it scored 1,125 for single core, 4,682 for multi-core. And we can take a look at the history here on that as well, since I've run it multiple times on this iPad. But you can see wherever they put November 17th and the 12th, you'll see I have about the same single core, a couple points lower, and a couple points lower for multi-core. Again, I ran this right after installing it, so that can change the actual outcome quite a bit. If I ran it again, I may see much higher scores. But either way, it feels very fast and fluid, and I don't really have any issues. Now, as far as new releases, some people are expecting iOS 14.2.1 in the interim before this comes out to the public, because Apple stopped signing iOS 14.1. So that means we only have 14.2 to go back to, and usually when they do that, it means an update is incoming. So maybe fairly soon we'll see that, as soon as tomorrow. And then I wouldn't expect another beta for iOS 14.3 until next week if we're on a weekly cycle. So maybe next Tuesday around that point. But hopefully we'll see an update to the public soon. And if we do, of course, I'll keep you informed about that. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.